Hey everyone, how's it going on? Welcome to Analytics School. This is session 25 in Base SAS Programming Series. In today's session, we were supposed to discuss about by variables. But before that, I would like to discuss about retain and sum statement. Since we are going to use this statement with the by variables, and that is why today we'll be discussing about retain and sum statement. And in the next session, we will discuss both these functions with the by variables and see their applications. When reading data in SAS, SAS sets the value of all variables equal to missing at the start of each iteration of the data step. Now, these values can be changed by the input statement, but they are set back to missing again when SAS returns to the top of the data step to process the next observation. Now, the retain and sum statement can change this. If a variable appears in a retain statement, then its value will be retained from one iteration of the data step to the next. A sum statement also retains a value from the previous iteration, but then it adds the value of an expression. Let's do an example and see how both these functions work and what are their applications. Now I'm going to create a dataset from the employee dataset where we are going to have an employee and monthly income, and monthly income is if less than 5,000, then the monthly income is going to be null. Let's run our code and see our data. So as you can see here, there is an employee number and monthly income, and if the monthly income is less than 5,000, it is null. Now I'm going to create a variable which will cumulatively add the value of an expression to a variable. So let's say if it is 18,844, it will add this value of 17,328 to the next data point. So it will be somewhere around 36,000. Now for the fourth observation, it will add that 36,000 to this 6,000, which will become 42,000. So we are going to create a cumulative variable which will add the value from the previous one. So let's see how we can do so. Now here I want to create a cumulative variable tot, and using the sum function, and I'm writing here the cumulative variable tot with monthly income. So what I'm doing here, I'm trying to add my monthly income from the previous data point to the current data point. However, when I run the code, you can see here there is an issue. I'm not getting my desired result. Now we are going to use the retain statement. Retain statement we use in SAS to preserve a value from the previous iteration of the data step. So let's use SAS and see whether we can get the desired output or not. As you can see here, I ran the new code with a retain statement. So I'm retaining the value of tot from the previous observation. So as you can see here, my first observation was null. Now my second observation is 18,844, which is picked up from the monthly income. However, in the third observation, it has added my second observation plus the previous one and add it into 17,328, which becomes 36,172. Now in the fourth observation, it added 6,347 into 36,172 and it become 42,519 and so on. In this way, I got the cumulative sum of the monthly income in the form of a new variable called tot. This thing can again done by the sum statement. Let's use sum statement and see how we can do so. So here you can see my first observation, which was null, is right now zero. Second observation is 18,844 and my third observation is 36,172. So sum statement also retains the value from the previous iteration of the data step, but one can use it for the special cases where you simply want to cumulatively add the value of an expression to a variable. A sum statement is more or so like an assignment statement, contains no keyword. And the form you have seen here, just writing what variable you want to create, cumulative variable, and what is an another variable you want to add the value into. So here it is monthly income. So this statement adds the value of the expression to a variable while retaining the variable's value from one iteration of the data step to the next. So in this way, we can use sum statement. Let's say we want to specify an initial value. Again, I'm repeating the word initial value instead of missing for the variable. And all the variables listed before an initial value will start the first iteration of the data step with that value. Let's see what it is going to do. So this particular statement retained toad 5000, it will initialize first value as 5000. However, rest of the null values will remain as null. So you can see here, my monthly income for the first iteration or the initial value where it is null, it has been now 5000. Whereas you can see in rest of the cases for with the cumulative sum, it is still null. It is not putting up there as 5000. In this way also, there can be some applications where you can use retain a statement to initialize the value of the first missing value as 5000. There are various other applications of retain with other SAS functions. Let's say we want to find out the maximum salary of an employee within an organization, and we want to compare the salary of an employee row by row. What does it mean is, let's say if there is an employee with salary of, let's say, 6000, and there are other employees with, let's say, the third observation has an employee with a salary of, let's say, 5500, it will keep the value of 6000 from the previous one. Let's say for the observation number 7, the salary changed to, let's say, 10000. So at the 10th observation, it will compare with the previous one, which is 6000 right now. However, since it has been increased to 10,000, it will replace that value. In this way, we want to use the retain and the max function to get the desired output. Now, here you can see 18,844 is greater than 17,328. So it is giving me 18,844. Now, here in the observation number 7, 19,141 is greater than 18,844. So the value has changed here. Similarly, if we go on observation number 26, 19,636 came. So 19,636 is greater than 19,189. So the value has changed. So in this way also, we can see the which is the maximum value or the maximum monthly income for the employees in the organization. Guys, this is the end of session 25. In the next session, we are going to discuss about the bivariables, and we will also see the applications of retain statement and the sum statement with the bivariables. Guys, if you like this video, then please do like and subscribe us. Thank you so much. Have a great day.